Hi, I'm Alan Little, AskWoodMan on YouTube. I'm also the owner of Very Super Cool Tools. And this is the intro video to a series that I'm going to show you about making a compressor, chiller, water separator. It's just something I designed and built over. I started it back in January, and I installed everything in May, so I just worked on it a little bit at a time while I was working on my other work. So this series is going to be a little bit disjointed, and in the steel fabrication of it, you know, since I would just kind of catch as I could the time to work on it, sometimes I didn't really film as much as I should have, so there are going to probably be some gaps that you may be asking questions about. But it's mid-August right now in Texas, and it has been hot. We've had, you know, of course I've seen hotter summers than this, but we've still had, you know, 20-something days over 100 degrees. And so really, really tough conditions for a compressor to operate in with hot, humid conditions where you're going to have real moisture issues in the tank. Well, my moisture issues are done because I've used the water chiller or the air chiller set water separator for a little over 3 months, and I give it a clean 100% success rate. It is fantastic. And so now I'm only draining, I'm on a schedule now where I'm only going to drain my tank at the first of the month. So whenever I give Poppy his heartworm medication, that's when I'm going to drain the tank. So I don't have to drain the tank anymore because the chiller water separator is getting all of the moisture out before it ever gets to the tank. And cooling everything down. So my motor seems to be running cooler too, because no longer is the tank heated up with 250 degree air that is then going to cool off and all that moisture going to condense out of it. Well, like I said, this is going to be a little bit disjointed because I worked on it in such a sporadic fashion, but maybe you'll get something out of it. Okay, thanks for your time. Okay, it's August 2nd right now, and I'm getting ready to drain my compressor. And I haven't drained the compressor since mid-June. When I first hooked up my chiller water separator, first I would drain it about once every couple days to see what was going on. Then I started a week, then I started 2 weeks, and then I realized, okay, well, I just need to do a really good test. So I think I'm at 6 weeks since I've drained the compressor. I know it was back in June, mid-June. So I'm going to drain the compressor right now and just see how much water is in it. And since I put the contaminant trap and moisture trap on the outfeed side of it, I have still never seen one drop of moisture or anything come out of that downstream tap. So trap. So I know that my chiller is really doing a fantastic job. When I was first using this compressor, when I really started using it, when it was just the compressor, you'll see the tray that I was draining into. I would fill the tray up with water. And now I'm just, I think there's just probably going to be just a mist in the bottom of it. And that's going to be all that's in there. So this is working really great. And I had seen, when I was using just the compressor, I had actually seen water coming out of my air tools. And now, nothing. I mean, the tools feel cool to the touch no matter how hot it is, and this is August in Texas right now, so high temperature, high humidity, so it's the most stressful time for trying to take water out of a compressed air system right now, as hot as the temperatures are. when these things are, when this is going, this is, you can go like this, you'll see when I turn it back on, and I mean, it just immediately, it's 250 degrees. And, but I can put my hand right here on the downside, and I can just touch it, because I've interrupted that, that system. But I'll show you that in a close up. So let me go ahead and drain this guy, and let's see what we get out of here. And I never bothered with this, you know, I never bothered with the automatic drain setup on this, because I knew that once I built my chiller, I didn't need to, I wasn't going to be draining this thing all the time anyway. There's a little water in there. Okay, we'll come back. Let me let it do its thing, and then we'll come back. Okay, let's see what we got here. So here's what we got draining out of the tank after not draining it for 6 weeks. Five, 6 weeks, something like that. Hot, humid, summertime Texas weather. And like I said, never seen one speck of anything come out of this. It's just unreal how well the chiller's working. So let me turn this compressor back on and charge it up. Normally I just open this up and just purge it really quickly, but I'm gonna just crack this a little bit because I don't want moisture blowing back up onto my camera. So I'm just gonna crack this gently. But this is the, this first tank here is the one that gets almost all the moisture, and then a little bit in this one and almost nothing in the third expansion chamber. So let me just crack these guys, and this is directly after I filled it up after draining the tank that you just saw. Almost nothing's coming out of here. It catches all the moisture here. It's not going to go back up into the, or I think it's hard to quantify, but I think I'm catching 90%+ of the moisture before it's ever getting back into the tank, because I've been running this compressor, like I said, for 5 or 6 weeks. Some days I've been it's been cycling on and off 20 to 25 times. I've been using it so much. And you saw how little water was coming out of the tank. It came out of the tank. Okay, that's it for this first time. Okay. This is working really well. Okay, so it's August 8th, it's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, it's at least 100 degrees, just the most brutal conditions a compressor could be asked to work in. This thing is just hot as a pistol. That one's pretty ambient temperature over there. So I've just run this compressor pretty much non-stop for 3+ hours. So let's see what we got in here. I'm going to purge all three. Thank you.
Okay, I've got a check valve at the other side, so this isn't, it, you know, doing this isn't going to drain the tank, because there's a check valve downstream. All of this water would have been in the compressor tank without my chiller, without my water separator. So, man, this thing is working fantastic.